reducing atmospheric carbon dioxide through direct air capture. Climate change is primarily caused by elevated carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. A promising approach to address climate change is the direct air capture method. In this process, air is filtered through a solution referred to as the sorbent to absorb carbon dioxide. This technology has the potential to remove over 10 billion tons of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere annually. Therefore, Dr. Radu Custelcean and his team at Oak Ridge National Laboratory have been developing simple, energy-efficient, and environmentally friendly direct air capture methods. Once captured by the sorbent, carbon dioxide must be released in a controlled fashion and either injected underground or supplied to industries that use it. As such, it's important to develop sorbents that not only capture carbon dioxide effectively, but also release it in a controlled, energy-efficient way. One class of sorbents that has been previously explored is inorganic alkaline solutions, which can quickly react with carbon dioxide in air. However, these solutions can be corrosive, and the temperatures needed to release the carbon dioxide are extremely high, around 900 degrees Celsius. Alternatives to inorganic alkaline solutions are organic amine-containing sorbents. However, amines are toxic and volatile and tend to degrade over time. Dr. Custelcean's team recently developed a class of sorbents known as bisaminoguanidines, or BIGs, which are similar to amines and dissolve in water to produce an alkaline solution. They showed how a solution of BIG can react with atmospheric carbon dioxide to form a solid carbonate salt, which can be filtered out and heated at low temperatures around 100 degrees Celsius to release carbon dioxide and regenerate the sorbent. Dr. Custelcean's team then paired amino acids with BIG to create a more reactive sorbent mixture. Amino acids are non-toxic and far less volatile than amines. They found that the reaction between carbon dioxide and the sorbent mixture was very fast. When the carbonate salt that formed was heated to 120 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes, it released most of the carbon dioxide. In the same study, the team demonstrated how concentrated solar power could be used as a source of sustainable energy to heat the carbonate salt and release the carbon dioxide. Dr. Custelcean then explored other BIG compounds that are cheaper and more effective. In one study, his team explored G-BIG, one of the simplest BIG compounds. They found that G-BIG was an effective and energy-efficient sorbent for carbon dioxide capture from concentrated streams, such as flue gas from coal-burning power plants, but it was inefficient for direct air capture. However, in a recent investigation, the team demonstrated that when combined with peptides, G-BIG led to an effective direct air capture process with significantly lower energy requirements compared to state-of-the-art technologies. To improve its direct air capture performance, the researchers incorporated methyl groups into the G-BIG molecule to create methyl G-BIG. They found that methyl G-BIG was much more water-soluble than G-BIG, leading to a significantly improved direct air capture process. The team is now interested in scaling up these systems and optimizing their performance. They look forward to collaborating with industrial partners to advance their energy-efficient direct air capture technologies from the laboratory bench to the real world.